Yes, a very good morning to all of you. Chaliye, let us continue with chapter number 10, circles, exercise 10.5. We have started exercise 10.5. Rather, we were on question number, I think 6 question is to be started today. Let us start with question number 6. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Let us make the figure. We are given ABCD, a cyclic quadrilateral. So we did the definition of cyclic quadrilateral, according to which a quadrilateral whose all the vertices touches the circle is known as cyclic quadrilateral. So we are making a cyclic quadrilateral like this. Raghav 8D, bache, it's not your mass period. It's been interchanged. Second period was of mass. So you please go to your interchanged period. Chaliye. So it is a cyclic quadrilateral. So we are given that angle DBC equals to 70 degrees. This angle DBC, this is given to be 70 degree. Next, it is given that angle BAC is 30 degree. Angle BAC, it is given to be 30 degree. Angle BAC, it is given to be 30 degree. And angle DBC is given to be 70 degree as shown in the figure. And he says, find angle BCD. First of all, we need to find this angle. So, you know, if I'm asking you that this angle ABC, it lies in which triangle, you will say triangle ABC, right? So if we are talking about angle BCD, which is to be find out, if I ask you that in which triangle this angle BCD lie, you will say triangle BCD, right? So this angle, it lies in triangle BCD. So, first of all, we will see that in this BCD, do we have other angles? That means if we want to apply angle sum property in triangle BCD for cracking this angle BCD, we should have other two angles. One angle is with us, but this is not known to us. First of all, our target is to find this angle BBC so that we can apply angle sum property to reach the required triangle. So I'm writing here, BC is the chord of the circle. BC is the chord of the circle. This BC, this is the chord of the circle. And you know, when we are having a chord of circle, so we did one theorem that chord of a circle, it subtends equal angle in the same segment. That means angle subtended by a chord in the same segment of circle, they are equal. So if I'm taking BC to be the chord of the circle and see the segment, one segment is here, which is below BC, and another is above BC. And this is the same segment. And in the same segment, this chord BC, at there are two points. One is A, another is D. At point A, this chord BC is making which angle? BAC. And at point D, this chord BC is making which angle? BDC. You should know how to see the angle made by a chord at a particular point. To see the angle made by a chord at a particular point, you have to start with the chord, go to that particular point and come to the another point of the chord. You will get one angle which is subtended by the chord BC and it comes out to be BAC. And then if you want to see the angle made by this chord at the point D, you have to go to point D. That is this point B, D, and you have to come back to C, B, D, C. So I'm writing. So therefore, angle B, A, C, this is equal to angle B, D, C. Reason is angles made by a chord in the same segment. In the same segment. they are equal. Angles made by a chord in the same segment, they are equal. So putting the value of BAC, we are getting BDC to be 30 degree. So you are having angle BDC to be 30 degree. Yeh aapke paas angle BDC aa gaya. Now you can shift to triangle BDC and you can apply angle sum property there to get your third angle. So I'm writing in triangle BDC using angle sum property, you will be having angle BDC. Sare ke sare ek ek center mein dete jao letter. Pehle D ko de diya humne. Now put B in center, DBC, and the third angle is C in center, angle BCD. This is equal to 180 degree using angle sum property, ASP. So putting the values of these angles, you will be having angle BDC. Right now we have find out this is 30 degree, and angle DBC, that is given to be 70 degree in the figure, and BCD is to be find out. So I'm writing it as it is. So 70 plus 30 comes out to be 100 plus angle BCD. This is equal to 180 degree. So you need to find BCD. So I'm writing angle BCD. This is equal to 180 minus 100. So angle BCD, this comes out to be 80 degree. So first target was to find angle BCD, and we have find out angle BCD. It comes out to be 80 degree. As you can see, we calculated it. Question is not finished till now. So we have to do the further calculation also to get the answer accordingly. Only two or three students of 9th D, I can see. 9th D, student of 9th D, Parmeet Singh. Bache, if you have your mass group, please inform your classmates to join the class. Otherwise, I have put the message in the group, in your class group. Actually, anyhow. So you can see it. Further, it is given, isi question mein, AB is equal to BC. This AB and this BC, these two sides are equal. So we know that sides, if two sides are equal, we should consider a triangle of which they are part. This is triangle ABC, in which AB is equal to BC. Ye dono sides hamare paas equal hai triangle. And using this fact, we want to find EC. We want to find ECD. This is E point where the diagonals are intersecting. We want to find ECD. That means this angle is to be find out, ECD. You know, this full angle we just have find out and it comes out to be 80 degree. Pura angle hamare paas 80 degree hai. And if we are able to find this much angle, ye wala angle hume agar pata chal jaye, then 80 minus this shaded angle will give us ECD. That means first of all, we should find this shaded angle, and let me mark it to be angle 1. So you will write here, AB is equal to BC. This is given to us. So this implies in triangle ABC, AB is equal to BC. This is given. This implies angle BAC is equal to angle 1. Isko maine angle 1 maan liya. This is BAC. By using the fact that angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Angle opposite to equal sides are equal. This implies BAC is 30 degree. So angle 1 is also 30 degree. We reach angle 1. It comes out to be 30 degree. On the other hand, we want to find this ECD. So let us see, according to figure, what ECD will become. Angle ECD, this is equals to this total angle BCD, ye pura angle BCD, minus this shaded angle 1, according to figure. Right, clear? So this angle BCD, we just have find out 80, and angle 1, this is equal to 30 degree. So subtracting them, we are getting 50 degree. This is that. So ECD को find करना थोड़ा सा complicated होगा, because we have to use this AB equal to BC concept, that sides of a triangle, two sides of a triangle are equal, then corresponding base angles will be equal. So this angle BAC equal to angle 1, angle 1 come out to be 30 degree, angle 1 की value हमारे पास 30 degree आ गई. So this angle ECD, this is equal to total angle 80 minus angle 1, and this gives you the answer, that is 50 degree. Right? बच्चे दिस चैप्टर इज यू कैन से दिस नीड्स मैक्सिमम प्रैक्टिस राइट सो डू मैक्सिमम प्रैक्टिस ओनली देन यू विल बी एबल टू क्रैक द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर राइट चलिए एनी हाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन Now, till now, whatever question we have done, they are based on the calculations. That means some angles are given and other angles are to be found out. Further, question number 7 onward, we are given theorem type questions. That means we have to prove something in those questions. Something is given and using which we have to prove other thing. Let us see question number 7, theorem based question. To prove all the questions, you don't give. But the question is, let us read out the statement. Diagonals of a cyclic quadrilateral are diameter of a circle through the vertices of the quadrilateral. First of all, we are having a cyclic quadrilateral. This is a cyclic quadrilateral. Diameter of the circle, diagonals of a cyclic quadrilateral are the diameters of the circle through the vertices of the quadrilateral. जिस सर्कल का ये क्वाड्रिलेटरल साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल बन रहा है उसके डायामीटर्स इस क्वाड्रिलेटरल के डायगनल्स हैं This is given. Diagonals of this quadrilateral are the diameters of the circle through which it is passing. That means ये जो मैंने दो slant lines लगाई हैं, they are satisfying the two properties. One, they are the diagonal of this quadrilateral. Very obvious. Diagonals are the line joining the opposite vertices. So they are the diagonals of this quadrilateral. And moreover, you can see that they are the diameter of the circle also. How we can say that they are the diameter of the circle? Because they passes through the center of the circle. So we constructed the figure in such a way such that both the conditions of the given, they should be satisfied that these two, they should be diagonal of the quadrilateral. Moreover, they should be the diameter of the circle of which this is the cyclic quadrilateral. पहले तो figure समझ आनी बहुत जरूरी है. Only then we can move further. So this is the situation. This is the given to us. What we want to prove, if such kind of cyclic quadrilateral is there, whose diagonals are becoming the diameter of the circle, then that quadrilateral is going to be a rectangle. This we want to prove. And this can be put in the form of MCQ that if the diagonals of the quadrilateral are the diameter of the circle through which it is passing, then that cyclic quadrilateral is going to be what? Four options must be given to you. Rectangle, rhombus, parallelogram, square, and you have to tick it on the rectangle, right? Actually, let us start with the given. Given is a cyclic quadrilateral A cyclic quadrilateral where AC and BD, सीधा लिखो, whose diagonals AC and BD are the diameters of the circle with the center O. कि इसके डायगनल्स जिस सर्कल में से ये पास कर रहा है उसके क्या बन रहे हैं डायमीटर. सो व्हाट वी वांट टू प्रूव, लेट अस सी टू प्रूव. ए बी सी डी इज अ रेक्टेंगल. वी वांट टू प्रूव दैट ए बी सी डी इज अ रेक्टेंगल. So I'm telling you the questions, these questions, they are in the form of the theorem in which some given is given to you and you have to prove something with the help of the figure and that given. Let us start with the proof. We want to prove that this quadrilateral is going to be a rectangle. One condition for a quadrilateral to be rectangle, it is very much obvious that it should the all angles should be 90 डिग्री. बिकॉज एक चीज तो यहाँ पे क्लियर ही है कि ये पैरेललोग्राम तो है ही है क्योंकि इसके डायगनल बाइसेक्ट कर रहे हैं. कैसे? OB, OD, OC, OA, they all are what? They all are equal. And we know that if diagonals of a quadrilateral, they bisect each other, that quadrilateral is going to be a parallelogram. Parallelogram की properties के through वो जो quadrilateral है वो हमारे पास parallelogram बन जाएगा. तो firstly we will write it is to be a parallelogram. And then we know that if in a parallelogram each angle is 90 degree, or you can say either even a one angle is 90 degree, then that parallelogram is going to be a rectangle. So first of all, we are writing that this ABCD is a parallelogram. So let us see here. OA is equal to OB. OC is equal to OD. As सीधा लिखो. Radii of the circle, radii of the circle equal होएंगी. Rather चारों भी आपस में equal होएंगी. Oh, sorry, हमें AO को OC के equal लिखना था and OB को OD के equal. AO is OA is equal to OC and OB is equal to OD. Radii of the circle. ठीक है, तो ये circle की हमारे पास radius होगी. This implies ABCD is a parallelogram. नहीं, सीधा लिखो, पहले लिखो दिस इंप्लाइज डायगनल्स एसी एंड बीडी बाइसेक्ट ईच अदर एंड दिस इंप्लाइज एबीसीडी इज अ पैरेललोग्राम. टू प्रूव एबीसीडी टू बी अ रेक्टेंगल, फर्स्टली वी आर रीचिंग द फैक्ट दैट एबीसीडी इज अ पैरेललोग्राम. So parallelogram should have one property with which it can be proved to be a rectangle, and that is its angles should be 90 degree. क्योंकि opposite sides equal हो गई, क्योंकि parallelogram है. तो अगर each angle 90 degree हो गया, then it is going to be a rectangle. So let us prove that how we are taking each angle to be 90 degree. Let us see. So now I am writing this. I want to prove this angle to be 90. This angle to be 90, this angle to be 90, and this angle to be 90. Very easy. Consider AC, the diameter of the circle. The diameter of the circle. Consider AC, the diameter of the circle. So this implies angle ADC is equal to 90 degree. Whatever theorem we did yesterday, that the previous day, I told you that they will be used in one way or the another way, and I'm using it. Angle ADC equal to 90 degree. Why? So if AC is the diameter, then angle in the semicircle this be right angle. Okay. Diameter ne circle ko do parts mein divide kar diya. Each part is a semicircle of the semicircle, and angle in the semicircle is always 90 degree. So you can write both ways. You can write ADC and ABC. Both are 90 degree. Similarly, taking BD as diameter, taking BD as diameter, if you take BD as diameter, then the semicircle is this one and the above one. You can take this angle, they both to be 90 डिग्री बाय एक्सप्लेनिंग द सेम रीजन. रीजन साथ में मैंने लिखा नहीं, आप लिखोगे. आई एम राइटिंग इन द नेक्स्ट वन. BAD इज इक्वल टू BCD 90 डिग्री ईच. सो राइटिंग एंगल इन द सेमी सर्कल. एंगल इन द सेमी सर्कल इज राइट एंगल. Angle in the semicircle is right angle. Right? So you see, we prove that ABCD is a parallelogram and each angle comes out to be 90 degree. So we will write, therefore we conclude ABCD is a parallelogram with each angle 90 degree. This implies ABCD is a rectangle. So the cyclic quadrilateral whose diagonals are going to be the diameters of the circle through which it is passing, it is going to be a rectangle. This was what we want to prove, and proof is in front of you. Next question. Non-parallel sides of wave. Just a minute. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 अभी रुको करवाती हूँ. सब पहले हम 9th 10th करते हैं, अगले क्वेश्चन करते हैं. 8th बाद में करवाती हूँ, थोड़ा लेंथी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद. सॉरी, क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद. टर्न ओवर योर बुक्स, पेज ऑफ द बुक. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. टू सर्कल्स इंटरसेक्ट ईच अदर. Two circles intersect at two points BC. We are given two intersecting circles. Intersecting at the point B and C. Through B, two lines ABD and PBQ are drawn to intersect the circle at the point A and D and P and Q. Through this point B, two lines are drawn. One line is PBQ, like this. PBQ, meeting the circle at the point P and Q. Intersecting lines, they're intersecting at B, passing through B. So one line is PBQ and another line is given to be ABD. So two intersecting lines, they are given like this. Through B, one is PBQ, another is ABD. And then the figure is completed by joining P to C, joining A to C, and C to Q, and C to D. This way figure is completed. बहुत easy figure है. सिर्फ ये वाली line और ये वाली line join करो. बाद में C, इधर वाले C को दोनों तरफ ले जाओ. C को P के साथ लेके गए, C को A के साथ लेके गए. All the points should be joined with C. C joined with B, C joined with A, C joined with D, C joined with Q. And the figure is completed in this way. But we want to prove angle ACP is equal to angle QCD. This angle ACP, this is going to be equal to angle QCD. This we want to prove. Let us start with the given. Given. Two intersecting circle. Two intersecting circles. Intersects at B and C. Two intersecting circles intersect at B and C. And two intersecting lines through B. Two intersecting lines P, B, Q and A, B, D through B. So this is given to us. And what we want to prove? To prove is angle ACP equal to angle QCD. This is what we want to prove. ACP is equal to QCD. चलिए, let us start with the proof. Proof शुरू करते हैं. See, ACP equal to QCD, this we want to prove. We will start with the left side of the true proof. In the left side of the true proof, it is written ACP. We will start with ACP. And if I am talking about angle ACP, do minute ke liye itni figure dekho. Agar main ACP angle ki baat kar rahi hoon, तो ये बड़े वाले सर्कल में मैं बात कर रही हूं, ठीक है. सो दिस एसीपी एंगल, दिस इज इक्वल टू व्हाट इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस सर्कल. एंड मोर ओवर, सबसे पहले ये देखो, दिस एसीपी एंगल इज मेड बाय विच कॉर्ड. इस सर्कल के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में इफ आई एम आस्किंग यू दिस एसीपी एंगल, इट इज मेड बाय डैश कॉर्ड, विच कॉर्ड यू विल आंसर. एनीवन रेज योर हैंड. Angle ACP is made by which of the chord? Tushar, Anshia, anyone else? Namneet. Anji, Namneet, you tell.
AC chord.
AC chord? AC chord is ACP angle bana rahi hai. Angle ki vertex C hai. To AC chord kaise hogi? AC chord kaise isko bana degi? Anshia, you tell.
AP.
AP code. ACP. A से start हुआ, P पे खत्म हुआ. तो इसका मतलब मैं dotted सी बनाने लगी हूँ. This code AP is making angle ACP. And when I am talking about this code AP, this circle is divided into two segments. One is below is AP, another is above AP. इस circle को आप 2 minute के लिए भूल जाओ. AP कोड के अकॉर्डिंगली वन पार्ट इज बिलो दिस, अनदर इज दिस अबव दिस. सो इफ आई टेक द कोड AP ऑफ द सर्कल एंड आई आस्क यू टू एंगल्स मेड बाय दिस कोड इन द सेम सेगमेंट, व्हाट विल बी योर आंसर? विच टू एंगल्स कोड AP इज मेकिंग इन द सेम सेगमेंट ऑफ द सर्कल? यस नवनीत.
ACP एंड ABP.
ACP एंड
ADP, angles in the same segment.
Angles in the same segments are going to be equal. So I am picking this ACP and according to this two proofs left hand side, I am making my strategy, going with angle ACP, looking in the circle one, taking the code AP and applying the theorem. Chaliye, let us start. Consider the code AP of the circle. Here angle ACP, this is equal to angle ABP, equation number 1, write the reason. Angles made by the chord AP in the same segment. Angles made by chord AP in the same segment. Right, equation number 1. नाउ दूसरा सर्कल में ड्रॉ कर रही हूं. ठीक है, ये हमारी फिगर का दूसरा हिस्सा था. चलिए नाउ वी आर रीचिंग टू दिस एबीपी. अब जहां पे रुके हो ना वहीं से आप जो है वो स्टार्ट करोगे. यू आर एट एंगल एबीपी एंड यू हैव टू स्टार्ट विद एंगल एबीपी. जहां पे आपकी क्वेश्चन नंबर वन खत्म हुई है हम वहीं से स्टार्ट करेंगे. रीजन माय एसीपी इट वाज लाइंग इन द फर्स्ट सर्कल एंड द अनदर पार्ट ऑफ द टू प्रोब दैट इज क्यूसीडी दैट लाइज इन द अनदर सर्कल सेकेंड सर्कल. किसी तरह से मुझे इस एबीपी के थ्रू बड़े सर्कल में से जंप करना है छोटे सर्कल. दिस एबीपी इट विल हेल्प मी टू जंप इन द अदर सर्कल बाय यूजिंग सर्टेन ज्योमेट्रिकल कॉन्सेप्ट. सी हाउ इफ आई कंसीडर दीज टू लाइन्स वन इज एबीडी अनदर इज पीबीक्यू देन यू सी these are intersecting lines and in case of intersecting lines opposite angles vertically opposite angles they are going to be equal so I am very intelligently I am shifting in the another circle by using vertically opposite angle that abp this is equal to qbd so I am writing also angle abp jahan pe ruke wahi se shuru kar diya angle abp This is equal to angle QBD, vertically opposite angles. Because these two are given to be intersecting lines. These are given to be intersecting lines according to question. So we can use their intersection and we can write that vertically opposite angles are equal. So ABP is equal to QBD. This is equation number 2. Now you stop at this QBD and you have to start with this QBD. You want to reach this QCD. If I ask you this QBD, QBD angle, it is made by which chord? Anyone? QBD angle, अब अभिनीत सही आंसर देना चाहती है. हाँ जी, QBD angle कौन सी chord बना रही है?
QD.
बिल्कुल ठीक. This chord QD is making angle QBD. And any other angle which is made by this chord in the same segment, अभिनीत?
QCD.
QCD, बिल्कुल ठीक. If I consider the chord QD, so हम लिखेंगे consider the chord QD. Here angle QCD is equal to जहां पे रुके हो वहीं से शुरू करो. Angle QBD is equal to angle QCD. Equation number you can say 3 using this theorem that angles in the same segment of the circle they made by a chord are equal. अब देखना जादू होगा और हम अपने रिजल्ट पे पहुंच जाएंगे. सो आई एम राइटिंग फ्रॉम 1, 2 एंड 3. एसीपी से शुरू हो जाओ. एसीपी इज इक्वल टू एबीपी. एबीपी इज इक्वल टू क्यूबीडी एंड क्यूबीडी is equal to QCD. So this was what we want to prove. इसमें से जो आपको चाहिए वो पिक कर लो. This implies angle ACP is equal to QCD. Hence prove. बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग थ्योरम है. ठीक है, सो वील कॉन्टिन्यू टुमोरो.